this is not the end. Live unbruised, we are friends. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
So, this is my story of how I helped my friend Keith and are helping him now with his fight with cancer. To find out at the age of 41, when you've got a young family, that you probably won't live a year, must be devastating. So this is my bit to help him. This wasn't going to be out there in the media or anything like that. This was from a closed group called the Builders Talk group on Facebook, and we managed to achieve all this through this group of about 17,000 builders, and I had guys come from all over the country to help me do this, to renovate Keith's house. And everything that you see and hear about has come from this group, this amazing band of builders, which I can't thank enough. And I can't really take the credit for doing all this, because it's the guys that have given me the ideas and pushed me in the right directions to help me do this. So the credit goes to them, not me. I've organised it, but I couldn't have done it without their help. So this is our story of the week we renovated Keith's house. If you've ever seen the programme DIY SOS, this is like that, but on steroids. In fact, not steroids, like crack cocaine. It's crazy. Craziest week of my life. And what we achieved was pretty monumental, considering we'd never had any media coverage or anything like that. We didn't push anything for the media. And the reason we're doing it now is because we want to take it a step further. We've realised what we've achieved to help him. Because he's one of us, you see. He's a tradesman like us, so we've helped him. We've mucked in together, and we've helped him one of our own out. So, you know, what you can achieve sometimes when you put your mind to it is pretty special. And although we can't take Keith's cancer away, personally, we can't do that. We physically can't do that. We can do a lot of other things. And a bit of compassion doesn't cost anything. And time and energy and skill that these men... doesn't really cost you anything, you know, to give up a day or two's work or a week or whatever you give us to help us do that. So that this is our bit for Keith. But a lot of the spin-off with it is a lot of other things as well. Obviously, we've raised a lot of money for him to put his affairs in order. So if the inevitable happens, he's got his funeral paid for. He's got kids' trust funds paid for. He's got things like that. You know, so we're raising the region of about £14,000 for Keith. To do that and send him away on holiday while we did his build as well. But the biggest achievement we've achieved really is getting a charity called Team Verico involved, a fantastic local charity that funds private health consultations with leading Harley Street doctors, and that's what we've managed to do. We've got Keith down to Harley Street to see one of the best ornithologists in the world, if not the best. So if he's got a chance, we've done everything we can for him, you know. So this is our story of that week, and the reason I'm putting it out there now is because although we did it without any publicity, I'm going to let it fly now. I'm going to let it go. I'm going to tell people what we achieved. And the reason I'm going to do that is not because I want to court any limelight or anything like that, or tell people how fantastic I am, because I'm not. I'm just a normal bloke. I'm covered in shit now, you know. There's nothing special about me. I'm out grafting, putting a fence up at the minute. There's nothing special about me whatsoever. But collectively, we've done something very special. And I think this story needs to be told. And I'm hoping people that watch this can join us and do this. Because we've done all this to Keith's house. It's a council house. He doesn't own this house. And he's never going to be in a position to own the house, but we've probably done over £30,000, excessive over £30,000 worth of renovations to the house. So my next step is now, I want to buy Keith's house for him. We've got a GoFund site, and I'm going to ask everyone to donate £10. If we can get about, I say only, maybe 90,000 people, 90,000, what am I on about? 9,000 people to donate £10, that's 90 grand, that should be enough. I don't know how much it's worth, maybe 90, 100,000 pounds. We can buy his house for him. And it's not about the money, it's about peace of mind for putting things in place for Sasha and Leighton and his kids, really, you know, so he hasn't got to worry about things. I'm sure if you speak to anyone who's got terminal cancer, one of their main concerns are, not themselves, but who they're going to leave behind and how they're going to cope. Although we can't help them with the mental side of things and in the turmoil they're going to go through, we can help them with the monetary side of things. So if you've got £10 and you think I'm worthy, or the cause is worthy that we've done to help this man out, let's make it go viral. Share it, do what you want with it, put it out there. And that's the only way we're going to do it. We need a lot of people to share this and a lot of people to engage. And if you get to the end of this video, if you've lasted for an hour watching this video, a full episode of like DIY SOS, but with a lot of swearing involved. So, you know, if you get to that end and you've watched it, that's got to be worth £10 for us to put in the pot. And I think you'll be pretty moved by what we've done and how we did it. So I'm asking for your help now. Can you help me buy Keith's house? Okay, guys, I'll leave you to it. I'll let you watch the video. The first part is Keith's thank you to the guys of the Builders Talk group. Again, just bear in mind, none of this was going to go out to anyone apart from them guys. So we've let it go now. We're going to let it fly. There is a lot of swearing involved. If you're easily offended, turn off, because you won't like it. If you can't, you know, stand a bit of swearing, this is not for you, because I know swear words that will make your toenails curl. So if that's the case, just go and watch an episode of Mastermind or something like that. But anyway, I'll leave you to it. So thanks for watching.
Right, my name is Keith, and I'm the guy who's got this cancer problem. Fucking devastated every day. Sorry. And you know, I've been through a rough few months, but anyway, this is not about me. This is about me. Telling all your people, thank you for what you've done for me and my family. You know, fucking hell, I've been an emotional wreck for fucking months. And what you people done for me is like, wow. I say you people, I mean you kind, decent, amazing people. I never even thought like people like you. The hardest thing is like, you know, living with this, and I got my little boy living with me. Fucking hell, I don't wish this on anybody. It's horrible. So if you've got a little lump in your throat, you go to the hospital, please. This don't only affect you, it affects your family. And he said, I'm gonna help you out, Keith. I said to him, like, you know, fuck me, Adam. Like, you know, you got your family to think about, you got your job to think about, like, you know. And he said to me, I want to do this, Keith, no matter what. And, like, you know, I was like, you know, you can't do no more. All I wanted him to do was finish off my fence. That's it. And he decided to do all this, like, and I'm like, wow, Adam. He even got the charity to take me down to London to see this professor. I thought I was big, strong, you know, bang, just like, what a pile of shit, man. But anyway, I gotta do like other people do as well, innit? I gotta fight on. And I'm gonna fight on for my family. We've got to try and live a bit longer. Some people ain't even going to have a friend like that, ever. And I got one like that. Whoa. He's my boss and all, like, you know. Known one another for years. We have a good laugh, a good crack, you know, like workers do. Take the piss out of one another. Fucking great stuff. Love it. Love getting up and going to work. Phew. Feel like a man. Now I feel like a fucking... They came here to work today as well. Broke my heart. Because I couldn't fucking do anything and I felt so ashamed of myself. Kids think I'm a bloody teddy bear. Come here. This is my little boy. He's got home from school. Wow. Loves me to bits and I love you as well, don't I? This is my girlfriend. Come here, sis. And she wants to say a massive thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
And she's a bit shy and, you know, but like, wow. Every single one of you, thank you. I've always wanted you to remember his name, Adam Smith. Wow. He's at my house today, doing some work for me. And you know, and, oh, all right, mate, all right. I love you. Oh, you dear. Mm. And, all I can say is thank you very much, everybody. Appreciate everything. I love you all, man. Amazing. Thank you.
Love that will not betray you, dismay or enslave you. It will set you free. More like the man you were made to be. There is a design in the alignment to cry of my heart.
I'm here now, so it's in touching distance. This is the start of the end for this. So this week is going to be massive. So come next Sunday when he comes back, you know, this, the look on his face and his family's face is going to be amazing. So that's why we're doing it. That's why we're doing it. You've all seen my videos and what have you, and what I've put up and whatnot. So you know what's going on. You know the full script now. I'm sure you've all seen Keith's video as well. You know, it's pretty hard hitting stuff to watch, so and that's why we're here. So thanks for coming. But reference the job.
Because I have other things to fill my time. You take what is yours,
bit of mayhem.
I'll take mine. Now let me at the truth, which will refresh my broken mind. So tie me to a post.
Day one. Just seen Keith off. The lads are cracking on now. Say hello, boys.
Hello.
Want this in the layout? What time is it, lads? About half 11, 12 o'clock? About 12 o'clock. These lads don't fuck about. All the flooring's out. Windows out.
quite fitting for what he's talking
about. So that's our story, that's yours, yours, that one's it, yours is it, Rob?
Why do you leave the fucking
knife? At least 50, I've lost count how many guys there is. I think that our count this morning is about 15 of us turned up, like in convoy. I think Simon put a video of it on, it's unreal. Pissing down with rain, everyone turned up, no one let me down. I was flapping yesterday, thought Ryan had bailed on me, but he just didn't have a signal. But it's unreal. So you won't fucking believe it. Kitchen's ripped out, everything's got, you know, front rooms ripped out, the lads are chasing in now, putting electrics in the wall. The plumbers have had some problems with bits and bobs, but they're putting stuff in now. You know, it's all going in. So it's all happening. I'm buzzing. I'm running on adrenaline at the minute. Weather's been shit, but who cares? You know, the lads are just cracked on anyway. They've got wet in the front garden. Not a lot we can do in the back garden because the access is terrible. But I'll catch up with that in the middle of the week. But you won't believe what's happened. The kitchen is actually ripped out, and we've been to Magnets and fetched the kitchen. That is going in. I think it's about 12:30 or something like that. 1:00. The kitchen's going in, so it's probably going to be in by end of today. Most of it, you know, maybe worktops tomorrow and what have you, but these lads don't piss about, you know, and they're all working on top of each other. If he was getting paid for doing this, the blokes would be taking lumps out of each other, but it's amazing, you know. I've had a couple of wobbles on the way about this, but I know I was doing, you know, my gut feeling was I was doing the right thing, doing what I'm doing, and I'm getting there. I can see we're at the start of the end now. So we just got to the end of this week, push it to the end of this week. You know, we're not earning any money. Are we going to go bankrupt? No. Are my kids not going to get fed? They'll still get fed. You know, so it's a week out of my life. Well, maybe a bit more for me, but, you know, a couple of days out of these lads' lives and they've all given up. You know, two Welsh lads come from South Wales. I was working the doors last night till 3:00, jumped in the van and then come straight up. Unreal. So everyone who's here is unbelievable. Lost for words. Thanks for sticking with me, boys. I know I've been a pain in the arse at times. I've been dogged. I've been fucking harassing some people, not the lads that are here, but everyone who's come. I've never asked them to come, they've asked me to come. But like all my suppliers and what have you, I've fucking give them hell to get fought tooth and nail for everything, and I've got it. I've got everything either free or for cost.
My life as it's meant to be.
Amazing man, every last one of them.
But it was not your fault, but mine. And it was your fault. I really fucked it up this time. Didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my
buddy lads? Wednesday. So we're smashing it out. I just got a bit of a. I want to ask a favour from some of the lads on the group. Craig, where are you? This lad here, he's come from Essex, right? He come on Sunday night, he stayed over. He's going to come for free. He's going to give me 3 days, bless him. Now, he said to me, he says, look, he says, I'm doing all this. He's putting the kitchen in, he's doing floorings, he's working all day today. He's putting a night shift in for me tonight, doing click flooring in the kitchen. You know, he's grafting his bollocks off. And now he's told me, he says, he can't go home. He says, I'm doing all this. There's no way I can leave it at this. I've got to see it through to the end. So he wants to stay. Now, what I'm asking is, if there's anyone out there or you lads want to sponsor him for his hotel for the rest of the week. His name's Craig Cottingham. He's a fucking great lad. He talks a lot, believe me, he can talk, but he's a cracking lad and he's giving up all his week for me to do this for Keith. So if there's anyone out there that wants to help him out with his accommodation, obviously he's not earning, he's put off a load of work to help me do this. Ring up the Ibis Hotel in Lincoln, and it is on Wisby Road, Lincoln. I'll stick the number up, speak to Sonia, the manager, and let's have this lad's digs paid for the rest of the week. Job in the world. I'm bald bag, but I've got the best job in the world, lads. Just for the lads I'm dealing with, you know. Got Craig stopping, the Ibis at Lincoln have been good. As soon as I put that post out this morning, fuck me, their phone was going off the hook. That was done. Done and dusted. These digs are sorted out. Tim, one of the lads, come from Essex again today. He just come for the day. He said, fuck this, I'm staying tomorrow as well. So he's jumping in the digs with Craig. I had sorted out a settee from DFS. Bloke from DFS was going to square me away a settee. Keith's old settee is fucked. He's a big bloke. The springs are gone on it. It's knackered. It took us ages to get it out. We took the window out and everything to get it out. It's a nightmare. And I'd hate to do all this work and put that settee back in. He said to me, he says, do you reckon you can get one of the blokes to put a bit of wood under the thing where the springs are gone, mate? You know, just so I can sort my settee out. Fucking hell, can't we sort a settee out? I'm going to go to DFS, just the manager, and see if there's any ex-display stock or out like that in Lincoln and see if we can get something squared up for Saturday and see if we can get one. But I can't afford to do it. I'm on the bones of my arse now financially. This has took everything out of me mentally, financially, physically and everything. So I'd love to go out and spend £1,000 on a settee. I can't do that. I'm not going to go bankrupt or anything stupid like that. And my money will come again in the weeks and months to come, and I'll get back on my feet again. That's not a problem. I'm not fucked by any means, but I can't dip into my money for £1,000. It's not there at the minute. But I'm hoping you lads can. I've seen now the response for the kitchen, what you mucked in. I've seen the response for Craig's digs, what you've mucked in. And I hope I'm not sticking my neck out too much. And we've got an opportunity to either smash it like we're doing. We are fucking smashing it. Or we can fucking smash it out of the ballpark. And I mean that. You know, why can't we get him a new settee and a new kitchen table? Not a massive one, nothing nutty, nothing, it's not going to be fucking diamond encrusted or anything like that. Just a nice kitchen table and a settee. Now, I'm going to put the link up for the GoFund site again. I've thought about different ways of doing it. Just the easiest way is me to do that. I've had a word with Sasha and she's happy. Any money that comes in from this day on, at the minute, for this part, I will donate towards doing that in the house. Also, the contingency fund's probably down to about £300 now. Things like we're only allowed for 2 skips, but we needed 3. You know, there's another £180 or whatever it is. You know, you times that by 6-7 times of all the stuff that of extras that we've needed, it's gone. So I haven't even bought the paint yet. So £300, it will be gone. There's more than £300 worth of paint's needed. So I'm going to set up the account again. I'm going to get it running again. And see if we can push it. And it's really only on this group. No one really gives a flying fuck on my own Facebook, but I'm not bothered, and I probably won't even put this video on my own Facebook. I might do, if you want to share it, have a look. In fact, I will, I'll put it up there. Bollocks, I'll put it up there. And if you want to share it and put it out to your mates, do that. We've got an opportunity now to really make this happen. It's going to happen anyway. But you can help me. you can help me do something amazing here. So let's do it. The kitchen's going in as we speak. Craig's just shot off to sort his digs out because Tim's staying tonight. They've got a double room, bless them. That'll be topping and tailing, won't they? And I couldn't have done any of this without your help. And everyone I've dealt with has been fantastic. There's not been one bad comment. Not one bad comment. No arseholes, no dickheads, nothing. Just been good, honest people. All the dickheads are too, they're not brave enough to stick their heads above the parapet. So I've just been dealing with the cream, basically. You know, for a man wanting to come from Belfast, get on a plane and come and help me with a day's tiling, that's the sort of people I'm dealing with. The Welsh lads come all the way from South Wales after doing a night on the doors, 3 a.m, jumped in the van, drove all the way down here, give me a full day in the garden, was on the chin straps by the end of it, you know, and then drove all the way back to Wales and be doing their own jobs the next day. They're the people I'm dealing with. Craig come for 3 days. He's now staying for a full week. He's staying right to the end till Sunday. You know, my lads who work for me, the work they've done has been incredible. You know, they've been doing, you wouldn't believe it, you know, they've been working as hard as I have on my own jobs to let me do this. So, you know, without these sort of people, I couldn't have done it. You know, and you've seen the pictures, you've seen the videos. So let's use this as an opportunity to smash it out of the ballpark. See what you can do, see if you can pull it out of the bag for me. You know, let's get Keith a new settee and a new kitchen table. You know, fuck DFS because they won't give me it. But, you know, we'll buy one. I'll just walk in there and I'll buy one. All right, cheers, boys. Still got loads to do. You know, the lads are still grafting. Still, you know, they've got still got a whole house to paint, whole house. So we've still got the plasters nearly drying here now. But all this has got to be done by tomorrow night, really. You know, still got plumbing to do. Still got tiling to finish. Painting. Still got a painting here. This is Keith and Sasha's room. All this needs doing. We've got a lot to do. It's touch and go. So it's all hands on deck. You can come, get down here, give us an hand. You'll not be in the way because I'll just delegate you in the right places. Got lads, you know. John's here under there doing a second fix plumbing. Kitchen's going in nicely. Kitchen's looking good. All this hallway needs doing. And we're doing this outside wall as well. So all that's getting painted as well. So, garden's looking good. Lads are putting a few bits in round there. And the artificial grass will be ready for Matt on Saturday. So it's all coming together. Just time is of the essence now. Oh, go on, Matt, you're all right, mate. One way in, one way out of this job. But what an amazing bunch of guys. These lads are doing night shifts for me. You know, Dan's come all, he's just taking John home to Swaddling Coat. He's travelling all the way back. He's putting a full night shift in for me. Staying over tonight. And he said, oh, I'll do whatever you know, whatever you want. And these are the people I'm dealing with. This is why it's been so easy for me. It's not been easy, that's not the right way of putting it, but I could have never done it.
We will live. In these bodies we will die. The way you invest your love You invest your life in these bodies, we will live.
Under pressure now, pressure's on. Pressure's on to get this finished now. Luckily we've got two decorators that have come in from Grantham that have pulled us out of the shit, because we wouldn't have done it. No way, we wouldn't have finished it by Sunday. If we didn't have two professionals in there doing smashing this house out as it is. They've only really started today. Oh, we had John come last night from Ipswich, all the way down from Ipswich, bless him. 4 hours it took him to get down here. He's put a full day shift in and a full night. I think he left at about 10 o'clock last night and drove all the way back. What a fucking star, you know. And he's done all the base coats and piss coats or whatever you call them and that. So it's give these lads an heads up for today. Now, reference the call out I put for help with Keith Settee. You smashed it. Fucking smashed it. I checked last night for the first time and I totted it up. And I reckon I've got easy $2,000. So I can get, I'm pretty sure I can get a nice three-piece suite and a single seat and a table and chairs for his kitchen with that. So that's amazing. Now the only thing is, we went to DFS yesterday and just to sound them out and say, look, what's going on? Obviously you led me up the garden path and you told me that we can have this, and then nothing. You can't get it to me. You're not going to do it. And I was like, well, no, it's not happening. I mean, Craig, who I was with, he was nearly fucking dragged the fucking manager out and he's going to drag him around the car park. But why would you do that? I can't understand that. But anyway, the thing is, you can't just walk into these places and buy a settee. It like takes 12 weeks for it to come. So my mission today is get around all the independents and that, see what I can find and see if we can get something out for tomorrow, because I need it for tomorrow, really. You know, worst case scenario, we'll have to put Keith's old one in and order a new one for him. But I'll be, I don't want to put that old one back in. But, that's my mission today. Table and chairs and a new sofa. So that's what I'm going to be on today. So cheers for that, lads. You've done that. That's not an issue. I'll still put the link up if you want to put a bit more in to help us out. You know, there's still bits and bobs we need. But $2,000, we should be have more than enough to do it with $2,000. Got some more cracking lads down here. Dan was only going to come for a day, bless him. He went all the way back to Swaddling Coat yesterday, dropped John off, and he's come straight back. Stopped in digging with Craig, and he's given us it right to the end. So, you know, these lads are, and he's a one man machine. This lad, he's fucking, his toolbox is as big as me. He says, oh, he's multi trade. You think, ah, oh, maybe he's, you know, not. He's fucking shit hot. He's fucking shit hot. He's doing kitchens, bathrooms. He's a sparky by trade. He's better than Craig. Fuck me. No, he's not. No one's better than Craig. Fucking Craig's here, look. He's still smashing it out. There's a bit of 4x2 there with Craig's name on it. And that's for him, because if he fucking finds any more jobs, anyone who's on site has got my permission to beat him till he bleeds and then he stops fucking breathing, because he's just, right, we'll do that. I keep catching him pulling skirting boards off and I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? Leave them alone, you ain't got time to do it. So, yeah, if he does any more, bless him, he'll be dead by tomorrow, because I'll beat him to death. No, he's a great lad, great lad. Right, I'll show you around, lads. John there doing a bit of painting. See, this is what we've still got to do. They've just put a coat on, wallpaper going on that wall. That's new door. We aren't going to change them doors. It was in B&Q yesterday. It was like, Craig was like, right, two of them. I'm like, mate, we ain't got fucking time. He's like, no, we're all right. These lads have pulled us right out of the shit. I don't think we'd have done it without them. Bathroom, look at this. This isn't just been done by halves. This is top draw. You know, we haven't fucked about here. These lads are like, they're not DIYers. They are the best money can fucking buy. You know, Lloyd come all the way from Wales. He was gutted he couldn't do longer, you know. He's put down lights in. I wasn't expecting any of that. You know, down lights in the
in the hallway as well. You know, wasn't expecting any of that. Clip flooring on the floor. Wasn't expecting any of that. I was just going to put lino down. It's fucking, it's done. All this plumbing work is unbelievable. You know, it's none of that was going to get done. It was just going to be quick swap over. Steve and Rob's done all that. You know, all boxed in. You know, tilers, I went and fetched the tiles, the tilers went, what the fuck are you doing? It's all multicoloured, so they just there to check them all back. I don't know, I'm just doing, that'll do, and that'll do. So they sorted all that out, they just took it back and sorted it out with Rich, at B&Q, new door in the kitchen. Right, this is Dan, this man is like a fucking one man whirlwind. I've never seen anything like it. I'll fucking try and find his toolbox in a minute. It's like about 8 foot tall. You can see what's happening. We're not fucking about doing it by halves. And every time I think, no, that can't be done. No one said to me once, you can't do that. They've just said, there's been no problems. All that's been on this job is solutions. If there hasn't been any problems, because people have said, well, that boxing in round the pipes here, we'll do it. And I'm like, well, you have to, like, yeah, no, we'll fucking do it. People have been saying to me, no, I'll do that. It's fucking crazy. These are my two lads, Craig and James. These lads have put up with a lot over the last few weeks. You know, they've been my backbone. I couldn't have done any of this without them. These lads have been like troopers. They're out here working for Note now, you know, because they want to get their money up and their time up for free. And I couldn't have done it without them. Fucking great lads. Fucking great lads. But today is the biggest day, really. If we don't get it right today, I'm going to come unstuck. I'm at the end of my physical, mental limits to do this. But it's happening, and we're still going to do it. It's sort of like carrying me along. It's got its own momentum now. If I fucked off now, it'd still happen, I think. You know? So, because these lads are amazing, and they want to see it right through to the end, and they're helping me out. I can't believe they're helping a stranger out. They've never met me before. Some of them have never met Keith. They've just found the story and just run with it, and it's just inspirational. You know, it does, you know, it's restored my faith in humanity. There's no one that's half-hearted that can't do anything. Tim, bless him, he come from, I can't remember, I think from Chelmsford yesterday, the other day. You know, he's not been on the, he's a manager for the council. He runs all the build, you know, all the maintenance for the council where he lives, and you know, he's near retirement. He's not been on the tools for about 10 years. He's been boxing in stuff, he's been doing all sorts, bit of plastering, bit of plumbing. He's been fucking amazing. He only come down for a day. Craig tapped him up, and he loved it. He stayed for 2 days and he said he loved it, you know, and he's ready for packing in, and he was brilliant. You know, he's a really nice bloke, and that's what all the lads are like. So, yeah, that's my update for today. That's this morning. I'm going to be another busy day and a massive day tomorrow. So, cheers, lads. Keep watching. Here's Nathan Lott. He's banged out a day shift at work, and he's coming to do a night shift for me. Top lad. That's the lad that, when I was stood in, when I rang up Magnet's Kitchens, see how they're getting on. He was stood there paying the last 50 quid off the kitchen. Yeah? What's the coincidence of that? What a fucking great bloke. Right, so let's have a look at this bathroom. And as you can see that. Shower. Toilet sink. Boxing in on that. It's like boxing porn. Is that good? So there's still a load more to do in Keith and Sasha's room. These boys are amazing. I'm still trying to get my head around how you can come and do all this work for some nutcase like me
to help me out to do this. I can't really get my head around it.
Do you know what I mean?
Come on, Craig.
Sorry, mate. Bit.
Come on. fucking hell. Let me have a look in here. Dan's still at it. He's had the same pair of fucking underpants on for the last 4 days, he has.
I've turned them inside out.
But look at his kitchen. Look at that. Look at the tiling on that. Get out of his way quick. So that's the night shift. And these lads have been grafting all day as well. A bit more tiling to do in the morning. Martin's coming in the morning. Decorator's coming back tomorrow, which is amazing. So we're on track. We're on track. Every day's a school day for me with this. I'm learning stuff every day about these guys. Really, just how fucking awesome they are. Sofa's sorted, lads. I'll tell you now, sofa's sorted. But that has took chunks out of me, that has. I've wasted a full day because of fucking DFS wankers. You know, like I said in previous ones, if you can't give me it, just don't lead me down the garden path. So I've gone elsewhere, local supplier, managed to get a three-seater and a two-seater, really good price. We all money, boys, I'm spending it well. There's plenty in the pot. When I tallied it up, there's about $2,000 that you've raised the other day. Shit, you know, so that's going to get a TV cabinet and a coffee table as well. Eight in the morning. Load of lads here already. Rich has just turned up from rugby. Still got loads to do. Got Tim come back. He's come back putting the rads on and blinds and that for us. Bless him. Let's chat. More work, please. Not yet. No. Last day in the madhouse. Artificial grass is down. Matt and his mate's been down and put all that in for us. I've got lads coming from all over. I've lost track of everyone's name now. Blokes from everywhere. It's mental today. Going to paint all this wall. We're going to go for it. It's been pissing down with rain all morning. Just got a bit of a break in the weather. If it oofs it down this afternoon with ball bags, we'll be knackered. But we're gonna chance it. So all that's going to be painted, that wall there. Lads are just rubbing down, getting ready for that. The garden is looking shit up. Still a lot more work to do though. Painters are going to get the spray gear on in here. Get everyone out. All right, Matt. Got Sparks doing the last bits. Tim's pulled us out of the shit. Come and put all the blinds back up. Fireplaces back in. Got Stu coming from Brum. He's made an oak mantle. Bespoke oak mantle for us. He's coming up, he's on his way to us now. So he's going to fire that on this afternoon. John's still firing in the bathroom, bless him. 3 days he's been here. He fucking hates me. All right, let's have a look at this, look at this, that is plumbing porn, that is. Look at that fucking tiling. Keith and Sasha's room, nice wallpaper in here, it's all decorated. How the carpet fitters are going to get in here, I do not fucking know. They're going to go mental when they see all this shit in here. Martin and Gav still smashing out the tiling. Bless them. Look at that. Still a bit more tiling to do. Decorators will be in here this afternoon. Literally, as soon as they finish tiling, Separators are going in there. I put Mike off. Mike's going to come tomorrow now and fit the front door. All the front's done now, all planting and that. I mean, look at that.
Chelsea did have it in the net. I think it was Pedro. Just
that's crazy with a 4v2 because he keeps finding fucking jobs and he's going to get beaten with that if he finds any more jobs. So, amazing. Can't believe what we've achieved. I'm buzzing today. I'm going to pop up and see Keith in a bit. I've not had a chance to even see him, you know, and see how he is really. I've only spoke to him a couple of times this week, so I'm going to dive up there and speak to him, see how he is. Hopefully we might meet up tonight. I think the farmer, John, where he's staying, he's got a big bonfire that he's going to set light for us, and we might go and have a few beers and a chat and that, and all meet up the lads that are here. So that'll be nice. And then obviously still loads to do tomorrow. I'm not picking the settee till tomorrow I think we'll have to pop the front window to get that in. The carpets are still going down. They've got to try and put them off as late as I can. Still loads to do, but we're going to do it. We're nearly there with it. So cheers for watching, lads. Cheers.
But you are not alone in this, and you are not alone in this. As brothers we will stand, and we'll hold your hand. Hold your hand.
What a week I've had. Best week of my life.
Your baby child, the one to whom you gave life.
I had the opportunity to work with the SAS of the fucking building world, these boys are. These are like the elite forces of the building world, you believe me. Best lads I've ever met. Don't get me wrong, when I left the army, 15 years ago, I thought I'd never have banter like it again and camaraderie like it again, and I haven't until now. But this week has just been the most craziest week of my life. So, I'm proud of what I've done, yeah, I am. Done something good, something very good. So, and these lads have helped me do it. And you all, anyone who's mucked in and contributed to this GoFund page and just the support and that have made it easy for me. I wouldn't say easy, I'm fucked, but I'm on adrenaline now, so I'm going to get a few pints down my neck later and let it all sink in. I think it's going to take a couple of days for it all to sink in, to be honest, because I don't know. I mean, back in 2 hours, so still got loads to do. So it's literally every day is just manic, absolutely manic. But the best bunch of lads I've ever worked with.
Keith's on his way. Yeah, he's on his way. Yeah, 25 minutes away. Okay. Lads are just finishing the step and he's sealing round the door. Can I just get a pass, please, eh? Sorry, mate. Pain in the arse, I know.
I know.
Right, so I'll give you the final tour. We're there.
We've done it.
Lads have been taking the piss out of me, saying smashed it out of the ballpark, smashed it and squared away. But as you can see, who's that left them there? As you can see, we've done it. What we've achieved this week is second to none. you know, I've had people, the two decorators were like ninjas. They are like decorating ninjas, you know. Yeah, I said to me, one of them come up to me earlier and says, look, we've been on jobs where you've done people have done similar sort of work. It's took 4 months. You've done this in 7 days. Maybe I was naive because, you know, if I was a project manager or something like that, that you'd just say, no, that's impossible to do all that work in 7 days for free. Because you know what my budget was on this? Zero. So, to do all this with a budget of nothing, and we haven't scrimped or scraped on anything, we haven't cuffed anything, everything's done to a top spec. So, you know, it's been a week of graft, like 1-2 o'clock finishes for me, 10 o'clock finishes for the lads. You know, I've had lads that have turned up at 8 in the morning. You know, Andy come from Ipswich, 4 hours, turned up at 8, 9 in the morning, grafted till 9, 10 o'clock at night, and then drove all the way back to Ipswich, 4 hour drive. You know, and that's just one of many, many, many stories that I'm going to tell over the coming weeks, if you can bear to put up with me anymore this. But, you know, we've done it, you know. Yeah, look, we've got a nice cabinet. There's so many people I want to thank. There's a lot of people that thought I couldn't do it. This is the only room we didn't manage to do, but, you know, Leighton's room, bless him, we basically stacked their whole house in this room. But we did manage to have enough money to buy him a new smart TV to plug his PlayStation in. I'm just doing this video now because I'm going to struggle, I think, when Keith comes and Sasha comes and the kids come. I'm going to struggle to keep it together. So I want to show you what we've done so I'm just not a blubbering mess. Kitchen. Look at the kitchen, look at the finish. You know, Martin and Wayne and his mate come after a full day's graft at work and then grafting for me till 10 o'clock at night for 3 nights on the trot doing the bathroom and this tiling in the kitchen. So we could get it done. And it, don't get me wrong, this tiling was only finished last night. Last night, they were still tiling that bit down there. There's grouting that bit down there. It's 7 o'clock last night before we went down to meet Keith. We've had a bit of a bonfire where we were stopping and, you know, so we all met up and what have you. Can't believe it, the lads are still painting outside. Look, there's still painting going on. There's his beloved Everton.
Oh, the warmth in your eyes swept me into your arms. Was it love or fear of the cold that led us through the night? For every kiss, your beauty trumped my doubt. And my hand told me. found the God that I once loved was the same that sent me into your arms. Oh, and pestilence is one when you are lost and I am gone, and no hope, no hope will overcome. But if your stripe strikes at your sleep, remember spring swallows snow leaves, you'll be happy and wholesome again when the city.
From the Shire.
Chiefs, how are you?
Spot on. Yeah, just thought we'd just send you this video to say it's been an absolute pleasure. I'll speak for both of us there. For the experience we've had with you guys over the weekend. It's been an absolute pleasure. Adam, you're a total star. And if there's anything that we can do to help you in the future for anything, mate, just let us know. We might have to fucking charge your mind. But we just like to say, just like to say, mate, all the very best to all of you lads with diamonds. And Keith and family, wish you the very best. And hope for a speedy recovery.
Chief,
just
like to say, thank you very much for letting us be part of it, mate. Had a great time. Top bunch of lads. Actually, top bunch of lads. You've done a brilliant job, mate, bringing it all together. And get it all sorted, mate. Everyone come together and work on that, but photographs are awesome, mate. Congratulations, mate. Keith, I wish you all the best. Good recovery, mate. Hopefully you're happy with the end product, mate. And, well, we'll see you all soon, mate. Take care of yourselves.
Yeah. Thank you very much. We'll definitely hook up for...
Hello to Frank Sidebottom.
Hey! Fuck off!
Frank says.
Alright, boy lover! Cheers, lads. We'll see you again.
Take care, boys. Cheers. But my heart told me.